The city of Waukegan is replacing about 20,000 water meters with a new automated meter, which provide for an accurate, timely, and reliable reading without having to gain access to customers' properties. The new meters, which will be replaced at no cost to the customers, will be able to identify high water usage and potential leaks. In addition, customers will be able to access their water usage and account information conveniently online. The first thing you need to do is schedule an appointment with Professional Meters, Inc. to have your old meter replaced with a new automated meter reader, AMR for short. Look for a postcard in the mail with the call information or call 866-270-9629. PMI will arrive at your scheduled time to install your meter. They will arrive on a truck or a van with a PMI logo. The PMI installer will have on a shirt or a jacket with a PMI logo and will carry a PMI ID badge. Installers will also wear booties over their work boots to ensure they do not carry dirt, mud, or water into your home or business. The installation process should take less than 30 minutes. The installer will take a photo of the old meter to obtain a record of your final meter reading and the condition of the pipes and fittings. The next step is to turn off your shutoff valves located on your water meter line near the meter. Remove the old meter and install the new AMR meter. The transmitter, which transmits your water usage data to the city, will be placed on a convenient location near the meter. The installer will take a photo of the new meter once it's installed. And that's it. The PMI installer will make sure everything is cleaned up, collect his tools, and head on to the next installation. You may receive a follow-up visit from a PMI manager to ensure your satisfaction with the installation and to make a quality control check of the meter installation. For more information about the automated meter reading installation program, please visit www.waukeganil.gov. If you have any questions regarding the meter installation, contact PMI at 866-270-9629 or the City of Waukegan City Collector at 847-599-2997.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the August 17th, 2015 City Council meeting. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Belko.
Present.
Alderman Taylor.
Present.
Alderman Cunningham.
Present.
Alderman Zeager.
Present.
Alderman Moisio.
Present.
Alderman Villalobos.
Present.
Alderman Newsom. Alderman Tempest.
Present.
Alderman May.
Present.
Invocation, Bishop Colburn, and the Pledge of Allegiance, please rise.
We thank you again for another City Council meeting. We thank you for your blessing. We never get tired of asking you to bless our city, bless our leaders, bless our citizens. Help us to be all that we should be. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have two groups with us today. They are baseball players from our Pony League and our Bronco League. They won national titles. They're here. My son is going to bring them up here so we can give them the recognition they so rightfully deserve. But in the meantime, there's been some debate about chickens. And I've got my point of view on that. So what I asked our animal warden, Susan Elliott, to come here and discuss this issue of chickens just briefly so we can have an overview. And hopefully at the end of this, unless someone wants to champion this cause, it's going to be over. So Susan, would you step up, please?
Hi. Is this on?
Done.
Okay, I have a lot of concerns about chickens in the city of Waukegan. I have concerns about how much acreage people are going to have, what the acreage is going to be for the chickens. I live in Beach Park and I own a farm. I have 6 acres, so I understand some of the things that you need to do for chickens. And I also talked to one of the trustees to find out, so I knew exactly why it was working over there. They only allow chickens if they have a half an acre. You have to have a half an acre of land. It's got to be fenced in, no roosters. They wouldn't even think of having houses like we have to have chickens. Absolutely not. People can say they don't make a lot of noise. They make a lot of noise. And you don't have to have a rooster to for those things to cluck really loud. My concern is, what would people do in the wintertime with the chickens? It's cold, they're outside. I know from experience, I say it every day when it's cold, why do I have horses? So I understand that when it gets cold out, people don't want to do certain things. I'm worried about, where would we house these chickens that come in? We already get chickens in the city of Waukegan. And not just one or two a year. I probably have to place a good 20, 25 a year. And I have to sell my soul to these farmers to take in a chicken. Nobody wants another chicken. And the roosters, we get roosters. And I know that would be not allowed here, but we'll get them. People will think they can have roosters. They'll bring them in. Then they're going to come to animal control when the neighbor complains. And then I have to figure out where they're going to go. And even farmers, they only want one rooster at their house. They don't want 10 roosters. I am extremely concerned about what could happen. We try to educate. My one goal in animal control is educating people how to take care of their pets. And some people just don't know how to do it properly. I have a very bad feeling what I would find with these chickens. I think I'd find them in little dog houses, little crates in the middle of winter. Can we have some great chicken owners? 100%. We have some of the best dog owners that I've ever met in my life, but we also have some of the worst. You can regulate it all you want and make all your rules. I won't be able to control something like this because there'd be way too many people getting chickens. It'd be such a fad. And then when the fad is over, where is all these chickens going to go? It's going to fall on the city of Waukegan and me. You know, where are they going to go? Are people, those people start slaughtering them? You know, I've been to houses where I've had a goat, you know, twice in my career, goats hanging up where the guy's ready to kill it. We can't kill chicken, you know, you can't kill your food on your property. It's illegal. And I have a feeling that will happen. And I guess from what Megan was just telling me, and I didn't even know this, chickens only lay eggs for a certain amount, 3 years, 5 years. Then what? What do you do with the chicken?
Stew chickens.
Stop.
Ask a question, I'll answer.
And you know, and I've thought of different, we've had this situation before. And you're not, so I had to say to the people, you're not allowed to have chickens. The chicken got into the neighbor's yard. The dog killed it. The people went crazy. They wanted the dog put to sleep. First of all, I had to tell the people you can't have chickens, and she got ticketed too, but then the dog gets a bite put on it. I mean, that's how Lake County operates, not how we have to follow the bites with Lake County. So if we got chickens all over the place, and that will happen because we have it right now, I mean, and it takes me three times as long to catch a chicken than it does a dog. I mean, dogs will kill chickens. And I don't want to see these dogs because the chicken flew into their yard. Now this dog's got a bite on it. Are we going to allow people to sell the eggs? Do they need a license like they do to sell an animal in our city? I mean, there's a lot of things we need to consider if we're even considering chickens in our city. That's all.
If I could comment, Your Honor.
Sure. Yeah.
Yes, Alderman Tempest, please.
You have to have the other side heard. You can't kill chickens. You just put two little nails there and you chop their head off. And you let them bleed and then you pluck them and eat them. Now, God, I don't know how you think you get your...
I knew that was coming, Larry.
Well, sure it's coming.
I knew that was coming.
You know it's coming.
We can't have people slaughtering animals for food in our city.
Well, that's crazy. By God, the day may come when you have to. The
but
day may come, you may have to.
Okay, Larry, that's fine. Well, anybody else have a comment?
Who wants to argue with me?
Alderman Valco, please.
I have a question, Sue. As a city boy, I don't know this. Are there any things disease-related to chickens?
Yeah, I've read of there's... they all have mites. That's a given, because the last chicken I gave to a friend of mine that has a farm in Green Oaks, she has the urban chicken thing going, and they have a business in Waukegan. She takes it to the chicken doctor. There's only one around. She told me that yearly she spends probably $2,000 a year on her 8 chickens. That's a lot of money. She takes care of her chickens. They get mites, they get parasites, they carry salmonella, lice, something I can't even pronounce, and some type of influenza. Do all chickens have it? Probably not, but we don't know where these people are going to be getting their chickens from, and then when they get loose.
Your Honor.
Any other questions?
Your Honor.
Alderman Cunningham?
You know, I really don't even know why we're debating this.
Well, we're not debating it.
I don't even know why we're talking
about it. I just wanted
to
make a presentation.
I mean, something of this nature, and I can remember when, as a kid, growing up on Utica Street, there was only one person who had a chicken, Mr. Stinnett.
Oh, Torellas.
Yeah. Mr. Stinnett, I think he had a chicken in, well, he had them all. But I think once we kind of outlawed that, I hate to use the word outlaw, but we passed an ordinance for farm animals. I know we're specifically talking about chicken, but I think we need to make sure we understand we're talking about farm animals. So our ordinance incorporates farm animals as a whole. It just doesn't single out chickens. So I do like the fact that from an acreage standpoint, yeah, you need that. You can't have that in an urban area. We all understand that. Mm-hmm. But for us to sit here, and I've seen the Facebook deal, and this is, we have more pressing issues to be dealing with in our community than worried about some chickens.
Yeah. I agree.
Thank
so
you.
So let's okay. Move on with this.
Okay,
let's put it to rest and move on.
Alderman Tempest asked me if I would allow him to give some words of wisdom.
Okay.
Alderman Tempest.
Thank you. I had chickens when I was a little kid, so psychologically, I kind of like my little bandies and my other chickens out on Green Bay Road. But we did have enough land to really support them. And I can understand why some people like chickens. My yard would be kind of conducive, but most places in the city probably would not be conducive. And I think that's part of the... We have so many rules today, you know. Wow. Yeah. But if you got the right acreage in that, I think, you know, in some areas, maybe we annex, they got to... You know, they could have them. But overall, I can understand the problem, and I do understand that, Your Honor. But it's kind of fun sometimes to talk about chickens.
It is.
No, it's not fun at all.
Oh, come on, Mayor. A little bit.
And
Larry. Get loosen up.
My final statement about this is that at the end of the day, and you get all done with all the diseases and coyotes coming to neighborhoods and all of that, if we do chickens, like you've said, 90% of dog owners are responsible, but the 10% that are not cost the city an enormous amount of money.
Yes.
If we bring in chickens, we need more people for animal control, more people for code enforcement, probably more people for public works to pick up carcasses.
In a city that
is, the taxpayers are barely able to make their payments because our taxes are so high, I cannot inflict higher taxes for those types of services, when if you need eggs like this, go to the grocery store. They're available.
That's right.
And bottom line, I can't do it to the taxpayers.
Okay, thank you. Okay, next. Thank you, Susan. Next, Joaquin Pointley, can I have the manager of the team, please? Would you please step to the mic and please advise the alderman and the people present what you accomplished? Please.
All right, I'm new to this, Mayor, so on behalf of the council, I believe I First, want to give thanks for the invitation of our Waukegan Pony A's, which are the 2015 Quad City Champions. And also, the 2015 Colt Champions, the Waukegan Pirates. And Charles will be up here in a little bit. First and foremost, I've been coaching at Beach Park for the past 2.5 years. And this past year, during the fall ball season, what happened was my boys asked me to help coach Waukegan fall ball because they really needed a coach. And when I came here, I absolutely seen a gold mine amongst our kids. Our kids were not worried about the $400 bats and $200 shoes and $200 gloves. They wanted a bat they can hit the ball with. And as a coach, that is the most valuable thing that I see within our community and our kids. So when I came here, we came here with a plan with the board to grow Waukegan baseball. The research that we've done back in the 70s, 80s, up to mid-90s, Waukegan was a powerhouse of baseball.
Yes.
What happened to our baseball program? We don't know. A lot of people blame it on Nintendo, PlayStation. I think as a coach, at the end of the day, regardless of all those electronics, it's really the parents' responsibility to make their kids more involved into sports. And I was real blessed to coach in a great set of kids. They're the reason why I came to Waukegan. I believed in them. They believed in themselves. One of the things as us coaches, we just don't teach the game of baseball. We teach valuable morals for the kids that they can take out throughout life, like never giving up, playing as teammates. I don't care if we lose by 20 runs. If we leave that field knowing that we gave it 110%, that's a win within ourselves, regardless if we lose by 20, 30 runs or whatever the case might be. So this year, the last time I haven't looked at the archives, but what I do know is the Pony League really hasn't won any championships. Last year they were 1-20. The year before that they were 2-17. The year before that they were like 1-17 or 18, whatever it was. And this year, I'm really proud to say that our Waukegan Pony, the Waukegan A's, they went 12-3. Wow. They scored over 200 runs against our opposing teams. That's a big turnaround within Pony League. And they went undefeated throughout the whole Quad City Championship. I'm really proud of our boys. I would like to have recognition for the Pony A's.
Young men, would you please step up before we'll get a picture? And coach, would you step forward, please?
Absolutely.
Good.
This is the future of our community right here. And he's absolutely right. Nintendo's, PlayStation have devastated our sports teams. When I was a kid, and I was a catcher, by the way. Where's the catcher at? There you go. When we were too busy on sports games causing confusion or controversy. Our coach made us toe the line, and we did exactly what he said. So I'm very proud of you, gentlemen, young men, and the coaches. You represent our community very well, and I'm very proud of you. Thank you so much, coach. This is for you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
come here to talk about the chickens. I can entertain everybody about it.
All right, so I have one more thing. Our success in our baseball program would never happen if it wasn't for the help for an active naval instructor at our Naval Office Academy, Coach Cody. Big round of applause for him. Coach Paco Alba, he's the motivator for our team. And I'm going to close out with this, Mayor, that this was one of the, actually, from what I know, the first year that our Pony League, we invited all Quad Cities, and we made a national team. Our national team went out to Orlando, Florida, to play at a national tournament. First time, we had about 3 weeks to put this team together, practiced really hard, and our teams, we played against Maryland. We tied Maryland 8-8. Kansas City, we lost 5-3. Now, look at the scores, how close they are. North Carolina, we lost 6-3. Orlando, 8-3. And in the championship round, we played against the Bahamas. And it was a great experience for our kids because our kids never gave up, considering they only played for 3 weeks.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mayor,
yes.
Can I just say a comment really quick?
Were you a catcher?
No, I actually was an outfielder.
Okay.
But just quick thing, boys. I grew up playing baseball myself for 6 to about 20. I did have the privilege of joining a traveling team and win a national title. So you guys will probably reflect on this the rest of your life. I reflect back upon my life, and that baseball portion of my time traveling, winning a title, is like a mile marker in my life, and this will be part of your guys' life. And you guys have learned and understand the concept of team and how to work together and trust the person next to you. So congratulations, and I commend you guys.
Thank you. As you know, because of budget constraints, we no longer have lifeguards or anyone to manage the beach. The next group of people have volunteered their services to our community and actually provided invaluable services to us on the lakefront. David, would you please come up and identify these volunteers?
All right, yes. And you were at the last council meeting, obviously. We spoke about volunteerism for the Scoop event. That spirit also traverses over down to the lakefront as well. So the backbone of our operation down at the lakefront right now is based on volunteerism as well. It's countless numbers of volunteers, hundreds of them, in fact, that come out every Saturday and Sunday for general cleanups. We also have a group of cleanup effort from the Waukegan Port District, as well as a general contractor that comes out and cleans. But that does not deal with the daily upkeep and maintenance. And the following people take it upon themselves to be there and do other duties as assigned, including safety, security, and the really bad stuff, cleaning up garbage. So to that end, we'd like to recognize Justice Maceo Morgan. Justice is always quick to volunteer for whatever it is. He sometimes runs the gate. He sometimes helps with enforcement of no watercraft and also garbage. Next we have Sir Jose Pepe Vargas. Pepe's there probably before Chris and I get there in the morning. Ishmael Guzman is not able to make it tonight. And also Josue Pesillas, the intern, is back at school. We didn't want to discount him. Back at the office holding down the fort is Christy Flores. We don't make her pick up garbage. And last but certainly not least, my brother, Christopher Logan.
Would you mind if I made a quick comment?
Absolutely, go right ahead, Alderman May.
Thank you. I just want to express my extreme gratitude to this group of people. You guys, I know firsthand what you are dealing with on a daily basis. In fact, I was down this morning, and Pepe was apologizing to me because he didn't get there till 11 o'clock this morning. This guy is our volunteer, and he's down there cleaning up the masses of garbage that was left over from Sunday. You guys, I see you in action. I see you all filling all the positions that need to be filled, and you are tremendous, and you are the reason why our beach is safe and family-friendly on the weekends. But I can't stress enough that as wonderful and as magnificent as this team of people are, it's still not enough. We still need some more attention down there. But boy, they sure got us through this season. And these guys are down there crack of dawn, and they're down there at 9 o'clock at night again, cleaning up from the day's events. They are unbelievable, dedicated volunteers. So from my heart, thank you.
Yes, thank you, Alderman May. Audience time, Jamie O'Meara.
Jamie O'Meara, 1318 Chestnut Street in Waukegan. I had no idea you were going to make this presentation, but I'm speaking as a resident of Waukegan tonight. And I was down Friday evening to the Steiner Pavilion to watch the Three Brothers play, 12th night, or what you will. And I was, it was interrupted, as you may or may not know, by the storm that came through, and it came through very suddenly. And I was absolutely amazed and thrilled at how quickly our volunteers cleared not only the Steiner, but the beach, which was packed because Friday night was very warm. The picnic tables were crowded. There were dozens and dozens of families participating in the picnic areas, and hundreds of people on the beach. And these guys cleared the beach in 20 minutes flat before a drop of rain hit. And if you witnessed it at all, that was a pretty fierce storm, and it came in really fast. I can't even imagine what might have happened if people weren't forcing families to get off the beach, because it didn't look that dangerous at first. And once that wind hit, though, who knows what could have happened. So as a resident, thank you. Although, as Alderman May mentioned, this is a very short-term solution, as we all know, and I urge the council to figure out a way to make our beach work professionally so that this is, you know, an everyday occurrence, that we all feel safe and that it's clean every single day. Thank you.
Thank you. Jane Ferry.
Thank you for the opportunity to speak. I am Jane Ferry, volunteer coordinator for ArtWise, and I love hearing about all this volunteering because that's exactly what I'm going to hit you with. On all of the chairs out here and already passed out to the council are handouts about ArtWise. ArtWise is a community cultural arts series offered by Waukegan Arts Council in partnership with the City of Waukegan. ArtWise will be an annual art-focused event centering on a theme that has broad community interest and reach. In this first year, ArtWise is going to be for those who serve in the military and will run from September 11th through Veterans Day. Downtown art galleries, the Waukegan Public Library, the Lake County Courthouse, the Waukegan Park District, the Waukegan History Museum, and Clockwise, Bowen Park, and Three Brothers Theater all have themed events around those who serve. The centerpiece of ArtWise this year is going to be Ryan Spencer Reed's photography, and that's going to be at Urban Edge. Ryan Spencer Reed is an award-winning photojournalist, internationally known. He was embedded with the 101st Airborne, the Band of Brothers in Afghanistan. And the photos he took while embedded speak to all of the experiences our soldiers who are sent to war on our behalf of our country experience. Urban Edge will be open Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. And we are looking for volunteers to come and sit in the gallery for 2 hours. Welcome the public in, hand out a program, sit and watch how they go through the gallery. I think that this opportunity, because it is part of something that the City of Waukegan is in partnership with, would be an awesome volunteer opportunity for the City Council, for the Mayor, his office, and city officials. Don't just put your name behind this as partnering with Waukegan Arts Council. Come out here and meet the public and support ArtWise in its first year. All of you, the little sheet that I just handed out, my name and email, or my number and email address are on the back of it. For those of you who are interested, you can go out to waukeganartwise.com to find more information. If you have any questions, I'll be here even after City Council, or again, waukeganartwise.com. Thank you.
Thank you, Jane. Art Cobb.
Good evening. Good evening, Mr. Mayor and council members. I am Art Cobb, Executive Director of Waukegan Main Street, and I just wanted to share with you briefly as I enter my third week of employment at Main Street. I wanted to say that I've had the opportunity to meet many of the business owners and partners here located in Waukegan. I've had an opportunity to sit down with many of them, listen to their concerns and issues as they operate their business, and input on sharing with me on how, you know, we can make downtown Genesee Street and the lakefront a better place for everyone here in the city of Waukegan. So I'm very excited that I'm having this opportunity, and very shortly I will be sharing the information that I've received with you, and hopefully that we can move forward in making the city of Waukegan better. Also, I wanted to share with you that upcoming events that we have scheduled for the next month or so here in Waukegan. First of all, beginning Saturday, August 29th, we have our 8th annual wine and art stroll. That will be a very interesting opportunity for the residents of Waukegan to meet the various business owners and also see some of the various art exhibits that we have here in the city. And then secondly, on September 3rd, we have our volunteer appreciation evening event at the Waukegan Harbor. Again, we are no different from the other organizations here that count on their volunteers to make their program successful. So we are extending an invitation for all volunteers and people that are interested in volunteering to come join us between the hours of 6 and 8 on September 3rd at the Harbor. And then finally, September 15th, we're having our Waukegan Main Street annual meeting. That will also be at the Harbor. Registration is at 11:30, and then at 11:45 we will start our luncheon, and we'll again extend the invitation for everyone to come to the Harbor and join us.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Blanks.
Mr. Blanks, Black Abolition Movement for the Mind, 801 McAllister Avenue. Mayor, the last time I was here, city council members, when I was here advocating on behalf of one of our seniors, Mrs. Reese, which is 72 years old. You asked me a question when I was advocating for her, was I a lawyer? And particularly, you quoted, you said, Chris, are you a lawyer? And with respect, Mayor, I would really like to humbly request that we address each other as you did, as my name is on the agenda, as Miss, as Mr., and I will address you all as Alderman and Alder Lady or whatever, because I'm really not feeling on a first name basis with many of the policies and procedures of the city, particularly when it comes to our seniors and the women of this city, and particularly black women. As I expound on that, let me explain why. Let's say one of the reasons that I'm not on a first name basis when it comes to issues like excessive force, when I have to, we're looking at a 13-year-old children, when 13-year-old children cannot come down here and leave your interrogation room without being bloodied and with a fractured nose like Jonathan Garcia, who I had to help get an attorney who is now suing the city for that, I can't be on a first name basis with those type of policies. And I can't be on a first name basis with the type of policies where Miss Eunice Sanders, who was once employed for the city, who is now suing the city based on issues of discrimination.
No, she's not. It's
well,
over.
Well, she went through it. She went through, well, let me finish. So, however you want to put it, but the suit did go forward, or she was attempting to. So in my opinion, I can't be on a first name basis with you when we have people like Dr. Charmaine Harris, who I sat and listened to you as the mayor and executive officer call this lady on her job to bully and intimidate her and tell her that she needs to hand in her resignation, and you had not even notified this city council. That was unprofessional and totally disrespectful. And I definitely can't be on a first name basis with you when I bring a senior citizen down here like Miss Mary Reese, who you tell her she needs to come back and make an appointment when she's been here twice. And at no time did you invite her in your office to sit down and talk with her, but you invited the man on that night to come in your office to sit down and discuss with you issues about chickens. And you have not called this lady in back and talked to her. So I told Ms. Reese that she is not to come down here because she's been to your house to discuss her issues and complaint. At no time did you take it upon yourself to invite her into your office to discuss and make her her matters priorities. And on that same night, not okay, giving no account
you.
About
thank
the
you,
chicken
Mr.
issue. And at the same night,
thank you, Mr. Blank.
You
it's
made
a pleasure.
It your priority to bring the man into the office to discuss chickens over the seniors, and that's totally uncalled
Lee
for.
England, Jr., please.
How y'all doing this evening?
Fine.
All right, I'm a performer, so I'm used to like addressing the crowd, all right? So my name is Lee England, Jr. I am a son of Waukegan, and I am a violinist. I've been playing violin since I was 6 years old, and since then, I traveled from here to Chicago to LA, and I've been very successful along the way. I've garnered the attention of the likes of Michael Jordan. I'm actually one of four instrumentalists who aren't athletes who are signed to Brand Jordan. So I represent Michael Jordan as a violinist, and I'm from Waukegan. All right, that's a big deal. All right. I went to Southern Illinois. I have 3 degrees in music, one in music education, one in audio engineering, and one in performance. And I've been traveling and performing throughout the world for, you know, the last 5 years or so. And I've been on TV a bunch of times. And I say all that to say that I'm back at home and I want to make a difference. I feel like I have benefited directly from the philanthropy of Jack Benny, and I've learned about his influence, not only just here, but globally, as I live in LA now. And I feel like I want to build my legacy as I live my legacy, and not like other artists who start charities in LA or start charities in New York. I want to start mine here at home. And so I've been working with this guy named Quincy Jones. I don't know if you know him. You might know him, I don't know. He's done a few things. But maybe 2 months ago, I was asked to perform at the Geffen Playhouse, which is a very prestigious theater in LA. And they were honoring George Lucas and Elton John. Lady Gaga came on and opened the night. I don't know if you know her either. And I was asked to perform during the middle of it. And I went on playing violin. I had a upright bass, cello, and a pianist to play along with me, to accompany me. And we did an arrangement of All of Me by John Legend. Now, this song was very touching for Elton John, actually. It was something that he loved, and that's why we actually chose that song to perform. In the midst of all this, Quincy Jones was there giving an award, a Lifetime Achievement Award, to Elton John and George Lucas. And when I stepped off stage, he was kind of waiting for me. So he says, you know, what's your name? What's your zodiac sign? That's really what he asked me. Our birthdays are 2 days apart. You know, his is on the 14th of March, mine's on the 15th. That's a whole nother story. But he asked me who did the arrangement of the music, and I told him that I did. And I think that was a big deal for him. So when he came back off stage, he had brought George Lucas and Elton John and Lady Gaga were all there. And at one point, they were all just like, what are we gonna do with this guy? So Quincy Jones takes it upon himself to put on a showcase for me, which was sold out and very, very, very successful. And what I understood from that show was that I can do that same thing anywhere in the world. And without even the influence of a Quincy Jones or a Michael Jordan or Sean Combs, I actually was on Making This Band, an MTV reality show, whatever, without their influence, I feel like it's necessary for me to do something bigger than just be famous. You know, like, that's easy. Like, that's
thank
cool.
you, Mr. England.
Yeah.
Thank you. If you'd like to stay afterwards, I know that Alderman Cunningham would like
well,
to speak.
There's just one other thing.
Quickly, please.
I would like to partner with the City of Waukegan and actually use the Genesee Theater to put on a big show and actually show the community that there's more ways to be okay. successful than
very good.
What's
thank
actually
you.
Going on.
Thank you. Katie Dunling. Katie.
My name is Katie Dudley. I live here in Waukegan. I'm a proud Waukegan teacher and resident and taxpayer for the last 22 years. And it's my honor to have had a chance to work with the last speaker, Lee England Jr. I met him 22 years ago when I started teaching here in Waukegan as an orchestra teacher. At the time, he was like 9 or 10. And I saw an incredible gift in him and a passion for music, and one of the things that I think is the most wonderful thing is that he wants to come back here to Waukegan and work with the city and perform here in the Genesee Theater and work with children. He's been back several times to work with my own students, and he comes back and he gives back. And as many opportunities as he's found being such a virtuosic musician, his heart is still coming back here, and I would ask Waukegan to consider working with a partnership with him because he's amazing. And he really wants to work with our town and with our children and our future.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Meg Albright. Ms. Albright?
I think she left.
She left? Okay. Okay, next is approval of the minutes, meeting minutes and executive session of August 3rd. Motion by Alderman Segar, second by Alderman Villalobos. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolutions, proclamation, presentation, appointments. An appointment of John Bartos to the Planning and Zoning Commission. John, would you please step forward? As all of you, I sent you his resume. Alderman Taylor speaks very highly of this gentleman. Sir, would you like to make a comment and tell us your background a bit, please?
Sure. My name is John Bartosz. It's a little confusing. People say Bartos. It's pronounced Bartosz.
Okay.
I come from the South. I come from Texas. I've lived in Illinois. This is my third time here. This is a grand total of about 8 years, and all of it in the northern Chicago area up in this region. My background is in engineering. I'm an aerospace engineer by trade. I spent a lot of years working in that industry. I've had the good fortune of being able to retire at a fairly young age and decided I wanted to get a little more involved in the community because it was always somebody else doing those things because I was always so busy. So I've gotten myself involved more in the schools. I'm a substitute teacher at my kid's school. I'm involved in liturgical music ministries. One of the things I'm most proud of is I work for a program called Project Healing Waters. I spend some time traveling out to Colorado, and we take returning soldiers fly fishing, give them some time to decompress, teach them a new hobby for themselves as they move forward in life. That's probably the thing I'm most proud of right now that I'm involved in. I worked with Ann in the recent election. I've been more involved recently in just getting people more involved in the political process, and I'm looking forward to working on the Planning and Zoning Commission.
Thank you. Any questions?
Your Honor, I am proud that he's here, and I think this should be a precedent of anyone being appointed to any board of any nature when it comes to the city of Waukegan, that they present themselves to this council. That should be standard. And if they don't, I'm telling you right now, I'm not voting for them. I think this council and the city, those who own these boards, needs to come here and see exactly what it takes to be a part of it. Volunteer is hard. You said it earlier. It's extremely difficult. Sometimes it's a thankless position. But once you say yes, once you get on the field, it's what it is. So thank you, sir, for being here. And I personally appreciate this. One of the things I've been talking about. Thank you, Your Honor, for sending that out and making sure that person is present to see the alderman. Thank you.
And well, motion by Alderman Taylor, second by Alderman Mozio to approve the appointment. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Welcome.
Thank you.
Russ?
Thank
you. Is Russ here? Russ Tomlin? No? Okay. Thank you, sir. Next is the Committee Reports, Finance Committee. Alderman Valco, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. The Finance Committee met this evening, and the Finance Committee voted to authorize the proper city officials to enter into an agreement with Deegan and Associates, LLC, to conduct analysis of the property located at 801 Market Street in an amount not to exceed $25,000 payable from the AMSCE Developer Cost Recovery Escrow Budget Code 100-80426. Your Honor, for those in the audience and the aldermen that weren't on the committee, this is coming out of a grant that was given to us in the amount of approximately $200,000. And what this is, there was some prior cleanup on this property, and this is going to see if there's anything else that's needed down there. It's not going to cost the citizens anything. So the Finance Committee voted, and I so move.
Motion by Alderman Valco, second by Alderman Cunningham. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco?
Aye.
Alderman Taylor?
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham?
Aye.
Alderman Zeger?
Aye.
Alderman Moisio?
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos?
Aye.
Alderman Tempest?
Aye.
Alderman May?
Aye.
One final thing, Your Honor, before I close this, is that there was 19 new business licenses given out last month for the city of Waukegan, and that's all I have.
Thank you, Alderman Valco. Public Works Committee, Alderman Moisio, please.
Yeah, before I start, I too had the privilege of teaching Lee England. I had him in sophomore health class. Who would have thought he'd be world famous, a violinist now, but he was always a great kid. And he knows what I'm talking about when I say he kept me on my toes, as most sophomores will. But he's like a lot of other kids I've been fortunate enough to come in touch with. They have a passion for life, and they become successful just like anybody else from anywhere else. Now the Public Works Committee. Item A, authorize the proper city officials to participate in the upcoming county auction in September to dispose of old and wrecked vehicles, and I so move.
Motion by Alderman Moisio, second by Alderman Tempest. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco?
Aye.
Alderman Taylor?
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham?
I'm going to say aye, but before I say aye, Your Honor, I noticed that an ex-police car, one of our police cars, you know, when we get to go to auction, do we rip all of our emblems and everything off of them? The reason I say that, I saw a Waukegan police car. Had Waukegan police on it, and even some of our yellow trucks sometimes. So I don't know how that works or what we want to do, but
it didn't look very stripped out.
I will make sure that occurs.
Okay.
I saw the same car. I had the same questions. So, yeah, it is a concern. Thank you for bringing that up.
Yes, aye.
Alderman Ziegler?
Aye.
Alderman Moiseo?
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos?
Aye.
Alderman Tempest?
Aye.
Alderman May?
Aye.
Item B, authorize the proper city officials to award a 2015 CDBG contract to the low qualified bidder D-Land Construction for amount not to exceed $135,000. Funds for this are available from CDBG funds, and I so move.
Motion by Alderman Moiseo, second by Alderman Tempest. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco?
Aye.
Alderman Taylor?
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham?
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler?
Aye.
Alderman Moiseo?
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos?
Aye.
Alderman Tempest?
Aye.
Alderman May?
Aye.
Item C, authorize the proper city officials to award the three new salt spreader contracts to the low qualified bidder Bunnell Industries of Dixon, Illinois, for amount not to exceed $33,803.28. Funds for this purchase are available in line item 100-910-126-494, and I so move.
Motion by Alderman Moiseo, second by Alderman Tempest. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco?
Aye.
Alderman Taylor?
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham?
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler?
Aye.
Alderman Moiseo?
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos?
Aye.
Alderman Tempest?
Aye.
Alderman May?
Aye.
Item D, authorize the proper city officials to issue an RFP for the programmable logic controllers and the supervisory control and data acquisition. This is for the water plant, and I so move.
Motion by Alderman Moiseo, second by Alderman Tempest. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco?
Aye.
Alderman Taylor?
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham?
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler?
Aye.
Alderman Moiseo?
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos?
Aye.
Alderman Tempest?
Aye.
Alderman May?
Aye.
Anything else, Alderman?
That is it. Thank you.
Economic Development Committee, Alderman May, please.
Thank you, Mayor. The Economic Development Committee met this evening. We did have a presentation from Mike Stevens from Lake County Partners, which I think was very interesting. Then we had one item for action. I'll take the Economic Development Committee recommends, and I so move, to approve the request for proposals for the vacant city-owned property at the southeast corner of Genesee Street and South Avenue.
Motion by Alderman May, second by Alderman Valco. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk. I'm sorry. A voice vote. All's in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
That's all I have, Mayor.
Old business. Item A, authorize a modification to the award for the streetlight project awarded February 17, 2015 to Kelsco Bennett of Gurnee, Illinois, by increasing the award to the sum of $342,292, an increase of $9,909 due to a Scribner's error. It was a mistake on our part when it was read. We corrected it. We're increasing that fee to where it should be. Motion by Alderman Moiseo, second by Alderman Tempest. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco?
Aye.
Alderman Taylor?
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham?
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler?
Aye.
Alderman Moiseo?
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos?
Aye.
Alderman Tempest?
Aye.
Alderman May?
Aye.
There are no reports or communications. New business recommendation actions by Corporation Council. Item A, approval of payroll dated August 7, 2015, the amount of $1,420,756.76. Motion by Alderman Valco, second by Alderman Cunningham. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco?
Aye.
Alderman Taylor?
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham?
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler?
Aye.
Alderman Moiseo?
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos?
Aye.
Alderman Tempest?
Aye.
Alderman May?
Aye.
Item B, approval of bills dated August 17, 2015 in the amount of $5,922,378.39. Motion by Alderman Valco, second by Alderman Cunningham. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco?
Aye.
Alderman Taylor?
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham?
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler?
Aye.
Alderman Moiseo?
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos?
Aye.
Alderman Tempest?
Aye.
Alderman May?
Aye.
Item C, approval of block parties. Motion by Alderman Valco, second by Alderman Ziegler. All's in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Item D, approval of raffle sales application for Waukegan High School class of 1986. Motion by Alderman Villalobos, second by Alderman Taylor. All's in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Passes. Item E, approval of Little Fort Lions Club annual Candy Day fundraiser, October 9th and 10th, 2015. Motion by Alderman Ziegler, second by Alderman Moiseo. All's in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Item F, approval of UMA Center's use of the Steiner Pavilion on August 22, 2015, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Motion by Alderman Cunningham, second by Alderman Tempest. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco.
Aye.
Alderman Taylor.
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham.
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler.
Aye.
Alderman Moisio.
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos.
Aye.
Alderman Tempest.
Aye.
Alderman May.
Aye.
Ordinances and resolutions. First ordinance, amend Chapter 14, Article 7, food establishments, Section 14483B, entitled Mobile Food Vendors, by adding Waukegan Municipal Beach as a permitted location. What we forgot to do was when we did the food trucks on Clayton Street between Genesee and County, is we forgot to incorporate that usage for the lakefront. Motion by Alderman Villalobos, second by Alderman Tempest. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco.
Aye.
Alderman Taylor.
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham.
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler.
Aye.
Alderman Moisio.
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos.
Aye.
Alderman Tempest.
Aye.
Alderman May.
Aye. Item B, resolution authorizing the transfer pursuant to the Neighborhood Stabilization Program of 2138 Georgetown Lane, Waukegan, Illinois, 6087, and 2140 Georgetown Lane, Waukegan, Illinois, 6087. Properties which were donated by to the city to Lake County Residential Development Corporation to recoup expenses incurred. Motion by Alderman Moisio, second by Alderman May. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco.
Aye.
Alderman Taylor.
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham.
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler.
Aye.
Alderman Moisio.
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos.
Aye.
Alderman Tempest.
Aye.
Alderman May.
Aye.
Item C, ordinance amending the Waukegan North Chicago Enterprise Zone within the City of Waukegan and City of North Chicago, Lake County, Illinois. Motion by Alderman May, second by Alderman Tempest. What this does now it incorporates Vista Healthcare into the Enterprise Zone, which allows them the opportunity to recoup some of the money invested in their building materials. That's what this is. We just expanded it, I think, a block. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco.
Aye.
Alderman Taylor.
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham.
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler.
Aye.
Alderman Moisio.
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos.
Aye.
Alderman Tempest.
Aye.
Alderman May.
Aye.
Item D, authorizing the City of Waukegan to amend its intergovernmental agreement with the City of North Chicago, which established the Enterprise Zone within the area of the city. Motion by Alderman May, second by Alderman Tempest. Roll call, please, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco.
Aye.
Alderman Taylor.
Aye.
Alderman Cunningham.
Aye.
Alderman Ziegler.
Aye.
Alderman Moisio.
Aye.
Alderman Villalobos.
Aye.
Alderman Tempest.
Aye.
Alderman May.
Aye.
Alderman's time, Madam Clerk.
Alderman Valco.
No comment.
Alderman Taylor.
I would just like to again, thank the volunteers who clean up our beach. The hours and the mess that they've been cleaning up, kudos to them. The city cannot thank them enough. Also, I want to congratulate the baseball teams. You know, it just goes back to we have lost letting our kids get out and exercise and just having fun. So to see that back in our city is just wonderful. That's all.
Alderman Cunningham.
I too want to echo the congratulatory and appreciation for those volunteers at the beach. But I'm going to also sound the alarm again, Mayor. I think during budget times, we're going to have to really consider putting some money on that budget to really get us a team that can have this beach like it's supposed to be. The volunteer thing really works, and obviously we can see that. There's the committed folks, and because they love Waukegan. That's bottom line. But I just think it's time that we put some meat and potatoes behind it to compound with the volunteers. I think we'll see that our beach will probably be the beach that we've been looking for many years. That's just personal opinion. But kudos to them and all of those who participated, from staff to the volunteers. We thank you and we appreciate you. Second, again, I want to echo the sounds of it is awesome to see these young men playing baseball, playing sports. It is awesome. I can't tell you what playing sports at Waukegan Middle School and High School did for me. And for him to, the coach to say, and I know Alderman Moisio, we used to have a baseball team somewhere in sectionals, super sectionals, if not going downstate. We had one, if it's not every year, every other year. And if we didn't have it, we had young men's coming up in the ranks, and you can see that. We have to get back to that's how you build that love for your city. I know it for me it is. Same thing with softball and basketball. I look at girls' basketball, my daughters, they play. Waukegan High School, don't have 12 girls on the bench. High school. This is the powerhouse of high school basketball, Waukegan is. Make no mistake about it. Any team that plays the city of Waukegan, they come to play because they understand the talent that we have, the talent pool that we have. We must put ourselves and invest in these kids. And I just love the energy that these coaches have, and from the name, I love that energy because I know what it can do to make sure they're successful young men and young ladies in their lives. And I agree with you, Alderman Villalobos, that is an experience they will never forget the rest of their lives. Last but not least, Mr. England, Alderman Mozio knows more than I did. I just had the opportunity to listen to him, to some of his music yesterday. I was just blown away. I could not believe that this type of talent came from Waukegan. I should believe it. But I said, man, you got to come to council meeting. You got to tell everybody about this. I was excited for him and the foundation he was, and then the vision that he has. I want to play at the Genesee Theater. I want this to be an annual event where I bring in all the artists that I know. How awesome is that? I was throwing David Motley's name out there, the mayor, everybody. That is what we want our young men and our young ladies to do, go out and be successful, then come back and bring that energy here. But what's really profound about all of this, when he started talking about Jack Benny, how he did not know the impact that Jack Benny had in the entertainment business. He knew it from around here as we do, but when he got out to LA and New York, how Jack Benny influenced a lot of other entertainers in that business. But our young boys and our young girls don't get that opportunity because they don't get out the walls of Green Bay Road. So I'm proud of him to come here and do it, and I'm very excited that he was supposed to catch a plane today at 10:30. I said, hold on before you cancel that plane. Call the mayor this morning. The mayor got me. Appreciate that, mayor. And I know our agenda was set, but to have our young people come out, that should be a spark of energy for all of us. That we put the time and the energy into our young boys and our young girls, they will be the Lee Englands of the world. And it's many more of them out there. And I say that to say this, that I see the sadness of our young men and our young ladies because I spend 2 or 3 hours a day in the county jail. And it hurts everybody. It just hurts so bad because I know our young men, our young ladies are bigger and better than that. But they have to get out there and venture out, and I'm here to tell you what sports did for me. It kept me off them streets, obviously along with my mom. But the reinvestment into our young boys and our young girls as they go through life, it will pay dividends for us. If it's not today, definitely tomorrow. And if I'm not mistaken, Mayor, I think somebody else who played in the orchestra with Mr. Lee England sitting right behind us, I won't say any names.
Yeah, she is.
Ms. Jones. Thank you. Those are my comments for the day.
Alderman Zeger.
I know we're... Sam's coming from as far as talent. My son today just finished his first record, and he also is trying to get to Hollywood, start doing shows. I'm proud to say he's from Waukegan, Illinois.
Alderman Moisio?
I might as well piggyback on that. If people don't know, go home and Google Lee England. It'll come up pretty quick. You got the likes of Quincy Jones. I think everybody knows that name, whether you know music or not. and everybody knows who Michael Jordan is. He's back in town suing Dominick's for using his name, and he doesn't usually let people use his name. If you've been keeping up with the news, unless they can guarantee him $10 million. I don't know if Mr. England is guaranteeing Michael Jordan $10 million, but the fact that Lee England can use the Jordan brand tells you that he's pretty special. So yeah, he is world famous. I didn't get a chance to tell him when he left, but like if he comes back, he's got to bring one guy with him though. Marvin Smitty Smith.
Yeah.
I know who Marvin Smitty Smith is. He's from Waukegan. He was a drummer on The Tonight Show for years. He's considered the best jazz drummer in the world.
He's a drummer.
We all know his mother, Edith.
Marvin.
We all know her. But two of maybe the best musicians in the world from Waukegan. And I'm going to talk to Lee and see if he knows Marvin and see if he can maybe get Smitty back here. I played with Smitty back when I was a youngster. I played the strings, not like Lee England, and obviously not anywhere near the talent of those two gentlemen. But and another issue, I mentioned it in committee meeting today. We turned a shovel over on the development on Grand and Green Bay for the bank. And people ask all the time, how do we get our tax rate down? How come we're paying so much? We have to have more development. We have to make the land that we have in the city of Waukegan worth more money. How do you do that? You take the spot where North States Bank was at that was just generating property tax, and you redevelop it, and now there's going to be a gas station and a small strip mall and the bank. So you're not going to get an increase in property taxes because the value is going to get up, but you're also going to generate sales tax. We had the numbers here when the project first came to it. I can't remember. We could probably get it for you, but that is the stuff that we need to do. And then we just passed an RFP for some land that the city owns down there on Sheridan Road. Right now it's not generating tax dollars because the city owns it. But if we have a developer that comes in and does something, that increases value because now we get property tax from it. So those are ways that the city staff is trying to generate more revenue. All the time we get to budget talks, people always say, well, just find people more. People. You can't find your way out of a budget crisis. It doesn't work. You can't find your way out of it. You have to create more revenue streams, more development, things of that sort. That's what helps the city generate more tax dollars, more money. That's what we need. Thank you.
Alderman Villalobos. Just kind of a couple of things that some of the other aldermen said too. Today actually was a great day for me in terms of showing the growth and excellence Waukegan has. As Alderman Moisio said, you know, the Grand and Green Bay, North State Bank, new development there is a great opportunity for us. Today we swore in a new officer, so our police department is growing, so that's a wonderful thing. The youth that we had with the baseball and the sports, winning championships, that, like I said, you know, for me, that hits right to home in my heart because I was a baseball player and I experienced as highs of winning titles, and it's a wonderful thing and a wonderful thing to experience. Lee England Jr., amazing. You know, that's an amazing story right there. So for as much as Waukegan receives the negative stigma that we have, and I really work towards getting for us to get away from it, days like today shows all the great promise and all the great things that have come to fruition already in Waukegan. So today was actually a really great day today, actually, and I love being a part of Waukegan because of today. Second thing I'd like to mention is an event that took place a couple weeks back. A couple weeks ago, President Obama announced his Clean Power Plan, and this is going to be regulated in states on how they deal with emissions and moving forward with clean power and clean power energy projects. And the state of Illinois has a great opportunity to be part of that and be at the forefront, and Waukegan has the opportunity to be at the forefront of it and really gain some positive momentum for this national trend that's moving forward. At the event, it was a celebration of President Obama's declaration. There was Senator Melinda Bush was present. We had a couple of Lake County board members, Mary Ross Cunningham, Sandra Hard, and Audrey Nixon. Alderman Ann Taylor was present too for part of it. And this is just like one of the great things that Waukegan can really gain some momentum on too in terms of community development as well. So through this process, I'd like to try to put forward a letter to the governor just saying, hey, don't forget about Waukegan. Keep us in mind as you move forward on the state legislation in terms of the Clean Power Plan. So I'm hoping to have time to talk to some of the other aldermen about this letter and discuss and see what we can come together with. So that's it. Thank you.
Alderman Tempest?
Yes.
Alderman May?
From North Chicago up to Waukegan. This year they're changing their event. It's going to be 5K for Labor Day, and they've secured Independence Grove. And what they're trying to do is broaden their base of participants, and they are inviting runners. Y'all know what I love second to the beach is running. So there's a 5K in Independence Grove on Saturday, September 5th. It's going to be a USTA course, which means you're going to have timing devices. So I'm putting out the call to all my running buddies and all the runners in Waukegan and from all over the county. Come on out. Support our local seniors. The township does a great job providing lots of services for our seniors. It's a great way to enjoy Independence Grove. Even if you're not a runner, you can walk the course. And it's a great way to support our local seniors. So I hope everyone will consider putting that on their Labor Day calendar. The other thing I want to touch on really quickly, and I'm just going to ask you, my colleagues up here, to look at these pictures. And what the pictures I'm passing out are from the beach this morning at about 11 o'clock a.m. Yesterday, the beach was, once again, we sold out all of our passes at the beach, as I'm sure the mayor's been debriefed. That's 200 passes for non-residents. And that is not an infrequent happening on the weekends at Waukegan Beach. And I was trying really hard to get some pictures from the beaches from yesterday, and I was there, and I don't know why I didn't take them. But for everyone to really understand the enormity of the masses of people that are on our beaches on the weekend. We can give you all the numbers and tell you there are thousands of people, and some of you may roll your eyes and say, yeah, you know, I'm exaggerating. But honestly, I'm not. It's quite a sight to see, and it's awesome. I mean, this is a destination that's gonna be our economic engine, and we know it. So the pictures I want my colleagues up here to see. We had people out there before 9 a.m., our volunteer crew, cleaning up, getting ready for the day on Sunday. We have someone come through midday, empty all the garbage cans along the parking lot, and then we have another service come through at 6 o'clock at night and empty all the garbage cans again, okay? This is while all these guys, Dave's team, Renegades, I think is what we're calling them these days, they're out there picking up garbage, handing out garbage bags to visitors to our beach, and constantly bringing the garbage back out. So after all this happens for hours and hours, and they do their last sweep at 9 o'clock, this is still how much of a garbage issue we have the next day. So as wonderful, and so I'm kind of chiming on the back of Alderman Cunningham, and I know, Mary, that you're fully aware and invested in our beach, but we truly do need to make an investment down there, because this is what's left over after all that effort is already put into our beach. There is just garbage all around our cans, and the port's helping us. We've had volunteers helping us. We need a sustainable, serious plan and a budget for the summer, next summer. And the mayor assigned a task force, and we are ready. David Motley's done a great job of getting all of the statistics and knowledge down of how the beach operates on the weekend. I just want to say I'm encouraged, and I want to thank the mayor for your support, because I know you're going to support us as we go forward, but we're going to need more help next summer for sure. And that's all I have, so thank you.
That's true, and you know, Alderman, I have to say, about 3 weeks ago when you called me and we had a conversation about the lakefront, the problem with the water coming on board, we took it upon ourselves to correct that problem. We more than quadrupled the size of the beach. If you go down to our beach now, you can actually see that it is a beach. It used to be just a small sandbox. It is a large beach now. The people enjoy it. They're flocking to it. We cleared areas away for recreational use while still maintaining the habitat
for the birds' migrations and for some of the endangered plants and wildlife down there. We got an order from the Army Corps of Engineers to cease and desist, but I called IDNR, Illinois Department of Natural Resources. I'm going to continue to take the dunes out until they tell me I can stop. We're going to try to claim another 50 feet of dunes for that area. We did file for a permit. We're asking now for their permission to take another 50 feet. I don't see an issue with it. Our environmental person, Gary Deegan, has filed the paperwork. So within the next month or so, we were going to resume moving sand to fill in the beach, because the beach still is not filled to an adequate level to keep water from coming on and pooling. So we're working hard. And Lisa, thank you for your commitment. David, my son David, has worked. David does not have a day off. No. Those of you who know David, David works 7 days a week. Every weekend he's at the beach, every weekend, for 10 to 12 hours. So.
Not next summer, though.
Not next summer.
Not next summer. But, and Mayor, I just want to chime in. Can I just come on the tail end of what you just said? We hope to get rid of 50 more feet while maintaining habitat and dunes for the species that are down there, because we believe there's a compromise.
Absolutely, and believe me,
we all can live together.
I got so much heat from people telling me that I want to destroy the beach. I don't want to destroy the beach. I want to make the beach usable for recreational use, to maintain our habitat, and to maintain some of our wildflowers and different things on the lakefront that are absolutely necessary. The dunes serve a huge purpose. They keep the sand from blowing back into the lake. I realize that. So believe me, every time I start going over my boundaries, Lisa May comes to my office and reminds me that there's things we can do to make it livable and usable for everyone. So that being said, motion by Alderman May, second by Alderman Cunningham to adjourn. All's in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
The city of Waukegan is replacing about 20,000 water meters with a new automated meter, which provide for an accurate, timely, and reliable reading without having to gain access to customers' properties. The new meters, which will be replaced at no cost to the customers, will be able to identify high water usage and potential leaks. In addition, customers will be able to access their water usage and account information conveniently online. The first thing you need to do is schedule an appointment with Professional Meters, Inc. to have your old meter replaced with a new automated meter reader, AMR for short. Look for a postcard in the mail with the call information or call 866-270-9629. PMI will arrive at your scheduled time to install your meter. They will arrive on a truck or a van with a PMI logo. The PMI installer will have on a shirt or a jacket with a PMI logo and will carry a PMI ID badge. Installers will also wear booties over their work boots to ensure they do not carry dirt, mud, or water into your home or business. The installation process should take less than 30 minutes. The installer will take a photo of the old meter to obtain a record of your final meter reading and the condition of the pipes and fittings. The next step is to turn off your shuttle valves located on your water meter line near the meter. Remove the old meter and install the new AMR meter. The transmitter, which transmits your water usage data to the city, will be placed on a convenient location near the meter. The installer will take a photo of the new meter once it's installed. And that's it. The PMI installer will make sure everything is cleaned up, collect his tools, and head on to the next installation. You may receive a follow-up visit from a PMI manager to ensure your satisfaction with the installation and to make a quality control check of the meter installation. For more information about the automated meter reading installation program, please visit www.waukeganil.gov. If you have any questions regarding the meter installation, contact PMI at 866 270-9629, or the City of Waukegan City Collector at 847-599-2997.